Hello, I'm live again. Day two of the challenge. We remember that I started this challenge yesterday, and today is the second day. So I'm gonna hold on a minute to see how many people that will be joining for today. Now, like I said, this is a 14 days challenge that I've been asked to do. And people sent me messages. In fact, today I've received so many messages of people that want me to treat their own question. But unfortunately, I'm not going to treat all the questions in one day. So what I did, I just picked one out of the messages I received today for this challenge. Now, can I quickly say a big thank you to those that watched the episode for yesterday and those that had sent me messages to say they really enjoyed the program. Thank you so very much. Now today I got a message, one of the messages, so I just picked one, and the person want me to, the question is this. I mean, Elizabeth, thank you so much for watching. God bless you. Thank you. Obi Akabusi, I hope I pronounced it correctly. Thank you so much for logging in. Now, the challenge for today is somebody has sent me a message out of the messages I received. So this is the message I picked to respond to today. The person said I should talk about any regrets that I have in my life and why. Okay, can I start by saying I actually don't have any regrets in my life? Nello, welcome. Thank you so much for joining. God bless you. So, as I was saying, the message I'm treating today is a fan has sent me a message asking that I should talk about the regrets that I have in my life and why. So, I'm starting off this by saying that in the actual sense of the word regret, I don't have any. And I'll give reasons why I said I don't have any. I've come to realize that whoever we are now and whatever we've become in life is as a result of the experiences we've amassed over the years. It's as a result of what we have been through. Because what you have been through is actually what had made you to be a stronger and better person. It had made you to have a lot of experience in your life. So that is exactly why I said I don't have any regret whatsoever. Yeah, in my life, whatever I've been through had made me to be a better person. Whatever I faced in life had made me to realize that there are people I can actually impart into their lives, because you can only give what you have. If you've gone through a lot in life, you stand a better chance to impart into the lives of other people. For instance, I'm going to give an example to buttress what I'm saying. If you want to join the military and you have two options, assuming you want to join the military and you have been given two options, one, either to go to somebody who had been a military man or woman to learn from that person, or to go to someone who hasn't been a military man or woman but had read about military, probably from textbooks and all that, who would you actually, in the recess of it, who would you want to go to learn from? You can respond by typing in your answer if you don't mind. Because for me, I know who I would go to get advice from. I will actually go to the man who has been there, the man who had gotten the experience, the man who knows what it takes to be a military man or woman. Because they say that experience is the best teacher. So I wouldn't want to go to someone who hasn't been there, who will just tell me theories. Life is not just theories, it's practical. Yeah? So if I go to the man who has experienced it, who has the experience, the person will not be able in a position to tell me, look, when you go there, this is the way you handle this, this is the way you handle that. And based on the information I will gather from that person, I will go and come out. And nothing will happen. You see what I mean? So that is why I said, the question, what are the regrets I have in life? I can tell you, I don't have any. I'm not saying I don't have any based on the fact that I haven't been through anything in life. No. Very, very far from that. Why I said I don't have any is because I really appreciate all that I have been through in life. Because those things I have been through in life, they are the things that I had compressed together to make me who I am today. They are the things that have been put together to make me a better person today. They are the things that have been put together that had made me to be somebody that could impart into the lives of others and into the society that I'm in. That is why I said I don't have any regret whatsoever. And don't forget that even the scriptures that we read, yeah? Okay, let me check. If we check Romans 8 verse 28, it says, all things work together for good. So if, for instance, I've been through something in life and I'm thinking, oh, this is not good for me, this and that. Do you know those things have been put together for my own good? Yes. For my own good, in the sense that it might be for me to learn a lesson out of it. It might be for me to be wiser. It might be for me to be confident, more confident person. It might be for me to be able to learn in the real sense of learning. There must be a lesson in anything we go through in life. The thing is, we don't read in between the lines. When we are being faced with something, we just like take it on the face value. We don't actually look and read in between the lines and think, you know, like 1 minute to just pause and say, what is in here for me? What is the lesson that God is actually using this situation to teach me? There must be a lesson there for you. That if you manage to go through it and come out of that situation, you find that you become a better and wiser person. You don't just become a better and wiser person by not going through anything. What experience have you got? What would you be able to tell someone? Okay, let me cite another example. I've used the military to cite an example. Another example I want to cite for women, we women. A woman that had been through the motherhood stage, like being pregnant and giving birth to a child, yeah, you will notice that when a younger lady is pregnant, you will stand at a better position, at a better platform to advise the person, eat this, don't eat that. Do this, don't do that. Isn't it? Even before the baby is born, you'll be at a better platform to advise the person. Even when the baby is born, you'll be at a better platform to say, when you're betting this baby, look at the way you handle the baby. There are actually some ways you bet a newborn baby. You can advise. Now, for somebody who hadn't been through that, what kind of advice would the person give? The person can give based on what she had read from textbooks. But that is not experience. That is what the person had read. Educational information. Not that you have experienced it. There's a lot of difference when you have experienced something and when you haven't experienced it. So that's why I said, whatever I've been through in life, I've got no regrets. Not even a dime regret whatsoever. None whatsoever. I have been through a lot. I'm not saying I haven't been through anything. People that know me personally, they can testify that I have been through a lot. But then it's making me to grow by the day, grow by the second. As I'm going through those challenges, I am growing. I am becoming a better and wiser person. Imagine, okay, let me set another example. Imagine Joseph. Joseph is one of the characters, one of my best characters in the scriptures. I love to talk about him because his story stands out for me. Yeah? Now, imagine what he went through from his father's house up until when he went to Egypt. All those things he went through, they were the things that were put together to make him have wisdom. Because remember, when he became the prime minister, he was the best in the land. You know why? Because he had experienced hunger. He had experienced want. He had experienced being a prisoner. Everything rolled into one. He had experienced it. Every kind of trouble you can ever think of, he had experienced everything. And now, after he had experienced all those things, he came out victorious. When he came out victorious and he was elevated, he was promoted, his position changed from being a slave or being a bond man, a bond boy, to being somebody, you know. Okay, let me take it from the brothers hating him out of jealousy. They sold him out of jealousy. They discarded him and all that. And he went to Egypt and all that. And at the end of the day, where he thought, okay, now he's now been sold. And now he's in this strange land. Probably somebody will have mercy on him and take pity on him and help him. But then trouble started again. You see, from one stage of trouble, they say from frying pan to fire. So he was actually moving from frying pan to fire. Now he went again, and Potiphar's wife with his her own trouble again upon his life and all that. But at the end of the day, all those things that he went through, they helped to shape him to become a better person. You can't get gold if gold hadn't been through the fire. So that's why I said, whatsoever thing I have been through, for the person that asked me this question, you know, this is my 14 days of being sincere, as sincere as I can be. The challenge is for me to be as sincere as I can be, to just bear my life. That's what I'm doing. So for the person that has asked me this question, yeah, I can tell you, like I just said, that I have no regrets whatsoever. Whatever thing I've been through in life, I give glory to God. Because they have helped to shape me. They have helped to make me to be a better and wiser person. That's why I got no regret whatsoever. So, today, I just want to use this opportunity to quickly say to us, you, whatever thing you're going through in life, look at the positive in it. Look at the lesson in it. Don't look at it like, oh, this trouble is so much. This, that. No. Look at the positive aspect of it. What you should concentrate on is, God, what are you trying to tell me with this? Because there are some ways we might be going into, you think is the best way, but you don't know that God is giving you a sign for you to retrace your steps. If God is giving you that sign and you're adamant, you don't want to listen, you are not picking the triggers, the signs in there, he will trigger something to force you to stand still. Remember when Moses was in the bush, God tried to get his attention, but he wasn't listening. Yeah? Because he was not listening, you know what God did? He had to trigger something by making the bush to start burning. So that bush that started burning was what drew his attention. All along, God was actually looking for his attention to give him the message to say, "Now, I want you to go and rescue my people." But he was not listening. He was not being sensitive to pick that message. And because he was not sensitive to pick the message, God had to trigger something by making the bush to burn. And that drew his attention. And then he stood still. So whatever you're going through in life, look at the positive in that very situation. That is what I will tell us today. Don't look at it like, oh, it's negative. Why is everybody this? Me, that. Let me tell you, the more experience you have in life, the better for you. Because when those people that have not amassed that kind of experience you have amassed, when they stand to talk, and you talk, there will be a difference. I'm telling you. When you're given a platform to talk, and those people, they are given a platform as well to talk, you'll be talking out of experience. And that experience is the best teacher. And when you're speaking, somebody will like, that is why when you see some people, they're like 30 years. When they're speaking, you say, where is this wisdom coming from? And you might see somebody that is 60 years. when the person stands to speak, it will look like it's a 20-year-old boy talking. Wisdom is not by age, you know. It's not by age. Wisdom is by the number and level and the years of experience you've amassed in your life. So that is why we should always be grateful when we face challenges. But then, being grateful when we face challenges is, are you able to pick the lesson inside that challenge? There is no challenge that does not come with a lesson. That's why I said, I don't regret anything that I have been through in life. Never. And I thank God, you know, like, I thank God now because I'm able to pick lessons from whatsoever thing I'm going through. That is why, you know, like, I'm able to use my experiences to impart into people's lives. Like, if you have been following me on my Facebook, on my page, Apostles Daughters page, that's my Facebook page, fan page. If you've been following, you know, like, what I write there is my mind. Yeah, if you want to know the mind of a man, a woman, read his or her book. Then you know the mind of that person. So if you've been following me on Apostles' Daughter, you will see that all what I'm putting in there is my mind. Then you understand the kind of mindset that I have. Why do I have that kind of mindset? Because of what I had been through in life. Because of the experiences I've amassed over the years. Those experiences had made me, had actually helped to fashion me to be a better person. So that's why I said I don't regret anything that I had been through in life. No. So for the person that asked me this question, I just hope I've been able to do justice to it. Yeah, I hope so. And I just hope you have picked something from what I have said tonight. That anything you're going through in life, don't start crying over it. Oh, why am I going through this and all that? Try and look in between the lines. Try and look deep for the lesson there for you. Look for the positives in that negative situation. There is no negative situation that does not have positive. Trust me. I'm telling you. Every negative situation, every negative circumstance you find yourself, look deep. You will find a positive in it. Some people, when God wants to announce them, let me tell you this. When God wants to announce some people, there will be like kind of catalyst somewhere. There will be controversy somewhere. And you'll be wondering, you being a human being, you'll be thinking, why is all this happening? But you don't know that is the tactics that God is using to announce you. You will not understand what is happening unless you put your ears down to hear that still voice. Some people will understand what I mean by still voice. The voice of the Holy Spirit is so still, you need to listen well to hear it. If you don't listen well, you will not hear it. It will just come and go. Then you would have missed it. So sometimes when God is speaking to us and we're not paying attention, he will stir up something. Whether we like it or not, that thing that he will stir up will draw our attention to what he's trying to tell us. Yes. That's it. Like the example I gave with Moses. God didn't need to make the bush to start burning. But because Moses was not paying attention, so he now felt, well, how else can I get this man's attention? Okay, this is a man that is used to the forest. He's used to the bush. He's used to, you know, like always in the forest. That thing that he's used to, let me use it to get his attention. And he had to stir up something. So that is the way it is for me and you today. So I will encourage you, whatever thing you're going through in life, please and please and please, look for the positive in it. Let us stop mourning. Oh, why is it only me? Hey, why am I the only one going through all this? Hey, this, that. If you don't go through it, who will go through it? We all have our different destinies. God has created us differently. The bigger you the problem, the bigger the testimony. That's what I tell myself. Yeah. I always tell myself, the bigger the trouble, the bigger the challenge, the heavier the blessing and the testimony. And will that blessing and testimony come if you don't overcome? You have to persevere. When that trouble comes, you have to persevere, get the lesson out of it, then put that lesson into motion. You can only act upon that lesson that you have learned for you to benefit out of it. But if at the end of the day, you've been through this, you've been through that, and the lesson in it, you're not getting it. Even if you get it, you're not putting action into it. You are not better off than someone who did not learn nothing. You know, there's a popular example I always use. I say, if you buy a book and you don't read that book and you put it in your shelf, yeah, you don't read it, and someone else did not buy the book, you are actually not better off than that person who did not buy the book. Because the knowledge is in you opening that book and reading it. The knowledge is not in you having possession of that book. Having the book on your shelf, that is not where the knowledge is. The knowledge is in you opening the book that you have bought. Then you gain knowledge out of it. If you don't open it, if you don't read it, you are not better off than someone who did not buy that book. Yes. So what am I trying to say in effect? What I'm trying to say in essence is this. If you go through that trouble and God is using that trouble to teach you a lesson that will make you a better person, then when you come out of it, you pick the lesson, but you don't make use of it. It's of no use. You will benefit when you get that lesson, you action it. In everything, action is so, so very important. Whatever you learn, if you don't put it into action or practice it, you are not better off than someone who never learned that thing. So whatever lesson you have learned in your journey of life, put it into action. Don't take any trouble that come your way as in positive, negative. No, see the positive in that trouble. That is why I said I don't have no regret in whatsoever that has happened in my life. No regret whatsoever. Maybe there's a position you're in and then God is telling you that, look, it's time to move higher. Yeah? Probably somebody is now a secretary in an office. I'll use this to cite an example as well. I really want this to sink into us because this is a question someone asked me. I've answered the question, but I really need somebody to get a lesson from my own experience. That's what this challenge is all about. 14 days challenge. Every day, somebody will give me something to talk about, and that thing will have to be related to my own experience in life. You see, somebody might be thinking, oh, how much experience does she have to talk? Well, as little as I have, I know that I can still use it to impart into somebody's life. I know somebody can as well pick something from it. You don't have to be 80 years to get experience. Some 20-year-olds, the kind of experience they have had in their life is more than someone that is 80 years. True. It all depends on what you have been through. That's it. All depend on what you have been through. So back to my example, I was citing an example with someone. Assuming somebody is working in an office and that person happened to be the secretary in that office, and then the person had been praying, oh God, I need promotion, I need a change of level and all that and all that, and God is giving you a sign that now is the time for you to move on, and you're not listening, you're not being sensitive to what he's trying to tell you. Do you know what he would do? God, because he had prepared a place, because you have prayed and he had actually answered that prayer that you have prayed, and now that still voice is coming, but you're not paying attention to that still voice, what will he do? He will put a catalyst in that office of yours, he will cause something there that will make them sack you. That is the way it is. Then when they not sack you, you know what will happen? You start looking for a job. At the end of the day, you wouldn't go looking for a secretarial job again. Because in your mind, all you wanted was managerial position. So what would you do? You go looking for a job, applying to be a manager. Before you know it, you apply to be a manager, and you get the job. What has happened? God had used that ugly situation to elevate your position. So would you say, oh, I regret this, I regret that? No. Things that happen to us, we shouldn't start regretting. No. Rather, we should learn the lesson from that very situation. Use it to better our lives, better the lives of people around us. That is the essence of learning a lesson out of what we have been through. If you haven't been through anything in life, I'm sorry. You don't have any much experience. I can't come and say, oh, can you advise me on how to do this or how to do that? You need to do the cooking for you to now say, oh, I'm a chef. You can't just read a book and come out to tell me you're a chef. No, I won't believe you. So you have to be somebody that had been through it. You have worn the shoes and you feel the pain. Then when I come to you and say, oh, this is what I'm going through, you will not be in a position to advise me based on your own life experiences. That is why experience is good. So whatever you're going through, please and please and please look deep. Check. Ask God, what are you telling me in this situation? What is the lesson here for me? And based on the line of your questions, you get answers. If you want God to tell you what he's trying to do in that situation for you, he will tell you. He will open your eyes to see what is there for you. Then you pick it, you run with that vision, you become a better person. Okay, I hope I've been able to do justice to the question I was given today. So the question I was given today was, what is the thing that I regret in my life? And my answer is, I have no regrets whatsoever. So on this note, I'm going to sign off. Thank you so very much to everyone that has joined. Tomorrow, I will be on the third day. I started this challenge yesterday. Like I said, maybe for people that just joined today, I have this challenge for 14 days. My fans on Apostles Daughter, I don't know how many of us know that I have a Facebook page called Apostles Daughter. That's my Facebook page. So I have, somebody came up with this idea that they really want to know me. And how would they know me? That they want me to talk about myself for 14 days, every day. And what I will talk about will be the messages they will be sending to me. So out of the messages, I'll pick one and talk about that particular one. So today, surprisingly, I got so many messages today, but I can't talk about all of them. I just had to pick one, which is the one I just treated now. So tomorrow, hopefully, I'm going to pick another message tomorrow and talk about it. So they said they want to know me. And I really appreciate it that there are actually people out there who really want to know me. And I'm like, this 14 days, bearing myself. I'm like, going to bear myself. Like the topic I treated yesterday, if you didn't watch it live yesterday, you could please go back and watch that one. It's interesting. I'm really enjoying it. And I just hope that everyone that is watching is enjoying it too. Thank you so much and God bless you. So I have to sign off now. Remember, I love you guys loads. Love you loads. Thank you so much for joining. God bless you. Good night.